Tonight, a two investigation exposes fan scams. Your favorite celebrity reaches out to you on social media, and before long, they're asking you for money.
New regulations are supposed to protect you from scammers who want your cash. Investigator Pam Zechman went undercover to test them out.
I have been loving Bruce Springsteen since the 1980s.
Mary, who asked us to conceal her identity, says she commented on Bruce Springsteen's Facebook page. She then got a message from Bruce.
And I'm like, oh, Bruce Springsteen, I'm good. How are you? Into this tunnel
of love. Did you think that you were dealing with the real Bruce Springsteen?
Yes.
A search of Bruce Springsteen's shows there are dozens of Facebook pages purporting to be the boss. The real verified account is noted with a blue check mark. Mary and fake Bruce exchanged pics and text messages for almost a year. The tone turned flirty. Fake Bruce told her he was getting a divorce and he said he needed money.
I sent him iTunes up to maybe $400, $500, $600 little by little every week.
But then fake Bruce texted her pictures of his stash of gold, saying he needed money to ship it from Dubai.
My mind was just so brainwashed. And I said, okay, how much money?
She ended up sending $11,500 via MoneyGram, Western Union, and cashier's checks to someone in Dubai.
I was vulnerable at that time. You know, it hurts. It hurts, and you feel so stupid.
For the record, Bruce Springsteen is currently married and is worth about $460 million.
Hey everyone, I'm Keith Urban.
Hey guys, I'm Hunter Hayes.
Celebrities have started warning fans to beware of these fan scams.
Please do not engage with these people or send them money.
And imposter scams was the number one fraud for the FTC last year.
The Federal Trade Commission says these scams cost consumers $328 million in 2017, with over 350,000 complaints.
If somebody asks you to send money through a money transfer or through an iTunes gift card or for a prepaid gift card, don't do it.
Recent court rulings obtained by the FTC now require money transfer companies to warn customers about possible scams. We wondered if they were following these new rules, so I visited 10 MoneyGram and Western Union locations.
I got a phone call that I won a lottery.
No, that's a scam. Don't send the money. No.
He's in jail and I have to pay the bond to get him out of jail.
Absolutely not. Do not send any money. That's a scam.
All locations either gave us verbal warnings or had signs posted regarding potential fraud. Our fake Bruce Springsteen victim concedes she was warned multiple times but chose to send the money anyway.
I was just so fooled.
Got a little nervous thinking, oh, I wonder if this is someone who is pretending to be Derek Huff.
Kathy Martin was nervous because the Derek Huff she met on Instagram had an odd request.
He said, would you want to donate to an orphanage house in support of me?
Martin reached back out to fake Derek during our interview, telling him she suspected fraud.
He's responding?
Yes, and his response was LOL, which is laughing out loud.
At least Martin never sent any money, but she warns.
It's hard to know what's real and what's fake anymore.
While there's no way to tell how many fake accounts involve celebrities, Facebook says that it has disabled 538 million fake accounts already this year. Mary did file a police report, but law enforcement is rarely able to help with these scams because the perpetrators are mostly overseas. We have tips on how to spot fake accounts and how to report them on our website at cbschicago.com. And Rob and Erica, the trick is to look for that little blue check.
The verification.
In the upper left-hand corner.
Oof.
Verification.
For a year she was talking to this Bruce, allegedly.
She was.
Yeah.
And it is a classic case where they gain people's
They impact them.
Yeah. And they gain their trust. Mm-hmm. And she was lonely and vulnerable and in a very difficult personal situation.
Okay.
And she got caught.
Yeah. Oh, thank you, Pam.
Thanks.